Now then, it's nice to see that bands, when they do eventually get snapped up by the majors, sort of keep probably most of their own imaginative spark and flair. We have the artist which we're featuring today, comes from All About Eve. They're going to be chatting, and here we go. We're going to be finding out now, what actually are they about?
Tim about 4 years ago, I think, and he is the longest standing person after myself. We gathered Andy the bassist to us about a year after we'd been together. I've been saying 4 years for so long, it's probably a lie. It's probably about 8 years now, I don't know. We learn to love and we learn to give. Like it was going to work. Tim was amazingly perceptive, because when he came down to join this band, which was basically just a collection of people who couldn't play music, and I'm the only member existing from that lineup, I don't know how he saw anything in it. It was very tuneless, and it was just bad. It was real trash, and thankfully somehow he had some belief in it, and we managed to persuade him to be one of us. We promptly then got rid of everybody else in the band and started afresh. Both self-taught. But that we came from different angles. When we met up, I was really into kind of like pseudo-intellectual, pretentious things and music of that type too, whereas you were more of a
goth,
rock and roll guy. Goth.
Major wouldn't have touched us when we first started out, and we probably wouldn't be where we are now if it hadn't been for the indie scene. But there is, I'd say, at risk of being slated, that at least 75% of it is pretty crap. But then again, 25% of it is good, so you can't really knock it.
You are an ocean wave, my love, crashing at the bow. I am a galley slave, my
enjoyed listening to good music. It's just that neither of us were capable of creating it at the time. So it was basically on the premise of what we would do if we could, that we saw something in each other's style or whatever.
I'll go along with that.
I thought that we would lose them, and I was worried about that for a long time, but thankfully they've been far less narrow-minded and narrow-sighted than we thought they'd be. They moved along with us, and that, from the letters we get and everything, it's something that they feel proud of, that we've made it, rather than precious about us, because we haven't actually had to change the musical style to get where we have today, which is, I think, where you can lose people. You start getting really smart designer clothes and all the things that you really shouldn't do just because you've got the money, and we haven't gone in for any of that. So thankfully they've stayed with us. It was them who got the last single into the charts, because nobody was playing it So, God bless them.